Here we have an iMac 2015 27 inch that does not power on. We do see a blinking first LED, and that's an indication that we have a problem with the motherboard. Right now, Big Boss wanna check and see if the board has any heat spots using a thermal cam. And look at this. Look at this. Where is the heat spot coming from? Okay, can you point your finger? Okay, so right next to the screw. We're gonna have to inspect this area and see what's going on. You can remove the board and we'll take it from there. We just disassembled the board and I want to take a closer look at the back of the board, and that's what we see. We see something flashing, and let me hold the thermal camera. If you can pinpoint the flashing component. Okay, so it looks like it's that chip. It looks like it's the chip in between. There's something in between there. Maybe it's a MOSFET. We'll have to check and see. The board is out, and the heat spot was coming from this area of the board, right here. I do see a chip. Initially, we found the heat spot from the back here, and Big Boss had this area labeled, but when we flipped the board, it turns out that the heat spot is coming from this area of the board. Let's take a look under the microscope and see what's going on. This one here, not the bottom one. The problem, this one was flickering, this one here. Okay, the one with the mark on it. The only problem with desoldering this chip is it's surrounded by aluminum capacitors, and these capacitors do not like heat. If we apply hot air here to desolder this chip, they're gonna most likely blow up and hit my eyes. It happened before when I was fixing a video card. I showed you how that capacitor can blow if heat is applied to it. So what we're gonna do is apply heat from bottom of the board or front of the board. Let's take a look and see what's on front of the board. That's where Big Boss labeled the area as being hot, and not much going on here. So it's safe to apply heat on this area of the board. The chip is out, and now the million-dollar question is, where are we going to get the same chip? And the million-dollar answer is, we have a donor board. Right here. We're going to heat up from the bottom, just like we did with the customer's board. We do not want any of those caps to blow up. Let's remove this chip, and then we're gonna install it on the customer's motherboard, and hopefully that will fix his iMac. Almost and out. Great. Now we're gonna go back to the customer's board, and we have it right over here, and I have my goggles on just for safety. I do not want any of those caps to blow up in my face. Okay, which way? So I'm applying heat from the bottom, and we're gonna have to wait until solder liquefies, and then the chip is gonna settle in place. It's gonna move in place. All right, and we should be good. And now all we have to do is try it. And hopefully the iMac will power on. All right, so we reassembled the board and we want to look for, whoa, look at this. Look at this, we have two LEDs now. Before we had one flashing LED, blinking, strobing, but right now we have two. And the reason we have two and not three or four is because the screen is not connected. On this model, we have to have the screen connected in order to see all four LEDs. Let's assemble the screen and we'll test it together. He's working on a Nintendo Switch, but we want to finish this one first. All right, so we reassembled the screen and look at this. We have four LEDs.
Oh.
And ta-da. Wow, look at this, beautiful, beautiful. Big Boss is the man, as always. The iMac is fixed. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and we'll do something else in the next video. Big Boss.
Very good.